everybody. My name is Jennifer Maker, and it's a beautiful day to show you how to make paper succulents like these beauties and the Great Maker Show and Tell. Now, I don't know about you, but when it comes to plants, succulents rank pretty high on my list of favorites. They are beautiful, they come in so many different varieties, and the best part, of course, is that they don't require much care. I mean, we all lead really busy lives these days, right? So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make a beautiful tray of paper succulents that is completely carefree, which means you can't kill them. And of course, that's because these succulents are made entirely out of cardstock. How great is that? Now, the materials that you need to make this beautiful tray of succulents are mostly just cardstock and glue. It really is that easy. Now, I'm using this 65-pound cardstock pack called Fields of Green. You can see all the our succulent greens in there. And I think 65-pound weight cardstock works best for shaping the petals into realistic looking shapes like you see here. You'll also want two sheets of 12-by-12-inch maroon cardstock if you want to make the paper succulents like you see here. And if you want your succulents to look super realistic like mine do, you can use these beautiful pan pastels and distress inks to color your cardstock. And I will show you how to use these in this video. Now I'm going to display our paper succulents in a tray, and I'm using this 10.5 by 14.5 inch rustic wood tray. The link to this exact tray is in our materials below this video. And to keep the paper succulents in the tray and not fall out, we will use 3 to 4 of these floral foam bricks, some 18 gauge wire, and a bit of artificial moss. Other useful tools include a hot glue gun, something to cut our floral bricks such as a hacksaw, some needle nose pliers, a quilling tool or a pair of tweezers, and a small wooden dowel. And you need a way to cut your paper, right? So you can cut it with scissors, a craft knife, or a cutting machine. I'm going to show you how to do it faster with a Cricut cutting machine. Now you can cut your succulents on an Explorer or a Maker, and those of you with a Cricut Joy, like right over here, can also make it, and I've made you a special file just for you to use. So let me show you where to get the free patterns for this project, and then I will show you how to cut, ink, and assemble your beautiful paper succulents. Step 1, get my free paper succulent designs. First, you can get my design files from my resource library at jennifermaker.com/340. Just go to the red bar at the top and look for libraries, and then either click get a password if you don't yet have one, or click enter the library. You can find the pattern by searching the page for design number 340, and then click it to download an SVG cut file for cutting with a Cricut or another cutting machine, a DXF file, and a printable PDF for cutting by hand. I'm going to show you how to cut this design on a Cricut cutting machine. First, upload the SVG cut file to Cricut Design Space. If you're unsure how to unzip and upload SVG files, please watch my SVGs Made Simple training series at jennifermaker.com/SVGS. Here's what my paper succulent designs will look like in Cricut Design Space. Step 2, cut your paper succulent pieces. My design file includes multiple succulents and some tropical leaves. Depending on your tray size, you may need to cut additional succulents to fit your tray. I use the medium-sized tray from my supplies list, and then to fill my tray, I cut everything you see here plus 3 extra succulents. Now, while this design looks complicated, it really isn't. I've broken it down into smaller parts to make it easy as possible for you. So let's take a look. So I broke up the design into 6 parts or groups. Each group represents a different color of cardstock, 5 shades of green, and then maroon. I've colored sets A through E to match the green shades in the cardstock listed in my supplies. Set F uses the maroon cardstock. Once you've uploaded the SVG into Design Space, it's ready to cut. All you have to do is click Make It in the upper right corner. Now, if you're using a Cricut Maker 3 or Explorer 3 cutting machine, select On Mat and then click Done. If you don't see the screen, don't worry about it. It only shows up for Maker 3 and Explorer 3 machines. On the next screen, the prepare screen, it should show 18 mats in the upper left corner. So go ahead and click continue. Now we will select the base material. I've selected medium cardstock, which I think is the best setting here. If you don't see this material in your base material favorites, like you see here in mine, click browse all materials. Then type medium cardstock in the search bar, and then select medium cardstock 80 pound, and then click done. I always select more for my cutting pressure to ensure a nice clean cut. We will use 5 different shades of green. We need 3 sheets of 4 different shades and 4 sheets of another shade, and then 2 sheets of maroon cardstock. It's not important which shade you go with first, just make sure you follow the mat cutting order in Design Space so that you cut the right number of each shade of paper. Okay, so apply your first sheet of cardstock to your green standard grip machine mat. Load your mat into your cutting machine and then press the flashing button to begin the cut. When your cut is complete, unload your mat from the machine, and then to remove the cardstock from the mat, I find it easiest to turn the mat over and slightly bend the mat away to release the cardstock. And this also helps prevent it from curling. Now place the next sheet of cardstock in your mat and continue cutting. Repeat this process until all succulent designs are cut. I used the Cricut Maker 3 cutting machine, and it took me about 2 hours to cut all 18 mats, just so you know. Now, as you cut your paper succulents, I recommend placing the pieces for each succulent into individual stacks or even into plastic storage bags. You will be cutting a lot of parts, and it's easy to mix them up or misplace a small piece, so this is a good way to keep everything organized. Here's a diagram of each succulent in the order in which they will be cut. Now, when I refer to succulent numbers when we assemble this project, please refer to this graphic for reference. Step 3, prepare your succulent tray. All right, so now let's get the tray ready for our succulents. Using a hacksaw or a knife, cut your floral foam and arrange it so it fills the bottom of the tray. Cut the floral foam so it doesn't exceed the height of the tray. You don't have to worry about the foam pieces being cut perfectly. This is kind of like putting together a puzzle. Once everything is in place, glue the floral foam to the tray. Add glue to the bottom of the foam or to the bottom of the tray, and then place the foam back into the tray. Continue doing this until all the foam is glued down. After you've glued all pieces of foam into your tray, we're going to add artificial moss to the top of the foam. To do this, just put a lot of hot glue on the top of your floral foam, and then press pieces of moss into the glue. You'll want to do this in small sections to avoid the hot glue cooling as you work. And I highly recommend that you wear hot glue finger protectors to avoid finger burns during this process. Remember, safety first. Continue adding hot glue and fake moss until the entire top of the tray is covered with moss. Step 4, assemble the succulents. Now it's time to bring our paper succulents to life. I'm going to do this by adding some colorful shading and dimension to my cardstock pieces with Pan Pastels and Ranger inks. So first, let me tell you a little about both. The Ranger Distressed inks are dyes. They dry quicker and they're more transparent than the Ranger Distress oxides. Ranger Distress oxides are pigments, more opaque, and don't dry as fast as the inks. I forgot to wear gloves and learned that these inks can be challenging to remove from your hands with soap and water. The dyes eventually came off my hands after 1 to 2 days, but for this reason, I highly recommend that you wear gloves when you're working with the Ranger Distress inks and oxides. Now, Pan Pastels are super soft, easily blendable, and rich in color. They're highly pigmented and require no drying time. Unlike pastel chalk, they are also low dust and offer a greater coverage. I found the pen pastels much easier to work with than the Ranger inks for this project. And no matter how much of the pan pastel you get on your hands, it washes off completely with soap and water. You may want to practice how to apply the inks and pastels, whichever one you choose to work with, before you actually put them onto your succulent pieces. So just take a piece of scrap paper and practice. All right, so now that you're familiar with the pan pastels and the Ranger inks and oxide, it's time for the fun part. Of course, coloring your succulents is completely up to you, but I think it makes them look more realistic. Okay, now let's put together our succulents. I'm going to assemble succulent number one, or as it's known in nature, the sedum suncatcher. For this, you need your cut pieces for succulent one, a cosmetic sponge, and the pen pastel in red extra dark. To keep your hands clean, wear your gloves. I also recommend using a piece of scrap paper or craft paper to protect your work surface. First, rub the cosmetic sponge into the pan pastel to pick up the color. I'm shading each leaf differently by alternating between shading the middle, end, and side. Apply the pastel starting at the leaf and push out to the scrap paper. Do not apply in a back and forth method. Once you've finished adding color to this side, flip the piece over and add color to the back. Now for the base piece, I'm coloring the innermost part of each leaf on both sides. Don't add color to the small rectangular piece of cardstock. This goes on the back of the succulent and doesn't need any color. You can use a brush to remove excess pastel from your cardstock if you need to. To mold each leaf, I'm using my Cricut scraper tool. So place the scraper tool near the middle of the leaf and pull to the edge. This technique is similar to taking scissors to curling ribbon. Don't pull too hard or you're likely to rip off the leaf. And I'm also alternating the direction in which I'm forming each leaf. Now right next, let's curl the base piece. We're going to roll the long piece with all the leaves using a quilling tool. You can make your own quilling tool, purchase one, or just use a pair of tweezers. So insert the cardstock into the quilling tool, starting at the end with the smaller leaves. Begin rolling the strip of cardstock around your quilling tool. When you come to the end, add glue to the end of the piece and secure it so it does not come unrolled. Now flip your succulent over and add hot glue to the entire bottom of the succulent and place the base piece on top of the hot glue and hold until the hot glue is cool. Now take a piece of floral wire and measure 1.5 inches from the end. Hold the wire with your needle nose pliers and bend the wire 90 degrees into an L shape at the 1.5 inch mark. Measure 1/4 inch from the bent corner of the wire and then bend the wire 90 degrees again using your pliers. Measure 1.5 inches from the second bend and cut your wire using wire cutters. Please be careful when cutting wire. You can wear protective eyewear to shield your eyes from any bits of flying wire, so always be careful. This is what your bent wire should look like when it's finished. It reminds me of a staple with long legs. Turn your succulent over and add a line of glue along the base. And place your wire into the hot glue with the legs sticking up. Immediately place the rectangular piece of hard cardstock into the center of the wire to cover the wire and the hot glue. And you've just made your first paper succulent. All right, now let's assemble succulent number two, also known as Semper Vivum. You will need your cut pieces for succulent number two, a cosmetic sponge, and scrap or craft paper along with your Ranger Distress Oxide ink and abandoned coral, if you want to make it like I am, of course. I highly recommend wearing gloves so that their inks don't stain your skin.
Press a cosmetic sponge into the ink pad and then lightly begin inking the outer edges of each leaf. Apply the ink beginning at the edge of the cardstock and work out. Do not apply the ink using a back and forth method. Then continue adding color to each leaf. Flip the piece over and add color to each leaf on the back. Continue adding color to the front and back of each piece. Don't add any color to the small rectangle piece of cardstock because you won't see that. All right, so next we are going to give each leaf some shape. We're going to use our Cricut scraper tool just like we did before. This is the same technique that I demonstrated with our first succulent. As you get to the smaller pieces, you may find the leaf difficult to shape with the scraper tool. This is where the wooden dowels come in really handy. Grab a 3/16 inch wooden dowel and wrap ends of each leaf around the dowel. For the two small triangle pieces, fold the three tabs up. To assemble the succulent, we will start with the largest piece and work our way to the smallest. Add hot glue to the center of the largest piece. You don't need a lot of hot glue, just a little bit will do. Place the next piece on top and stagger the leaves. Continue until you've glued all of the pieces together. We're going to add floral wire to the bottom of the succulent using the same process we did for succulent number one. So measure 1.5 inches from the end of the floral wire and using needle nose pliers, bend the wire 90 degrees. From the bend, measure 1/2 inch before making the second 90 degree bend. This is because our rectangular piece for this base is wider than the piece that was used for succulent number one. Now add a line of hot glue to the bottom of the succulent that's slightly less than the length of your rectangle piece. Place your floral wire into the hot glue with the legs up and place the rectangle piece of cardstock between the legs of the wire and press into the hot glue and hold until the glue has cooled. And there you have it. Succulent number two is finished. All right, so succulent number three is called a Sedum Sieboldi, also known as an October Daphne. In addition to the cardstock pieces for succulent 3, grab a sponge, gloves, and the Ranger Abandoned Coral Distress Oxide Ink. Use a piece of scrap or craft paper to protect your work surface from stains. Press your sponge into the ink pad and then feather the sponge onto the very edges of each leaf. You want a nice bright line around the edges. Continue adding ink to the front and back of each piece except for the rectangle piece of cardstock. Take your scraper tool and mold each leaf using the same technique that we did for succulent number two. When you get to the smaller pieces with two leaves, use a 1/4 inch dowel to shape each leaf. Assemble the succulent from the largest size piece to the smallest, making sure to stagger the pieces. Then add the floral wire using the same method and measurements that we used for succulent number two. Now let's assemble the Monstera leaf. It's not a succulent, but it looks really pretty with this, I think. Using the permanent green pen pastel with a cosmetic sponge, I'm adding color randomly to various parts of the front and back of the leaf. I'm using my scraper tool again to give the leaf some shape. Now cut a piece of floral wire approximately 3 to 4 inches long and then cut with wire cutters. Add about 1 inch of hot glue to the end of the wire and place 1/2 inch of the hot glued end to the back side of the leaf where the stem is. Take the stem of the leaf and begin wrapping it around the other half of the hot glue. And there you go, you have made a beautiful Monstera leaf. Our next succulent is an Echeveria Rainbow, such a pretty name. Assemble the succulent using the same steps as you did for succulent number one. This time, color the leaves a little different. Use the Ranger Crushed Olive Distress Ink and add a stripe in the middle of each leaf. Then use the Coral Distress Oxide on each side of the green stripe. When you've finished adding color to the front, continue with the back side of the piece. Follow the same steps from succulent number one to assemble and add the floral wire to the bottom. Okay, grab your pieces for the next succulent, Sedum neuspomeranium, also known as coppertone sedum, along with yellow ochre and Hansa yellow pan pastels. As with the other succulents, you will need your sponges and a piece of scrap or craft paper to cover your work surface. Start by using the yellow ochre pan pastel. Press a cosmetic sponge to the pastel and then gently brush the color on the outer half of each leaf. Now take the Hansa yellow pan pastel and apply highlights at the bottom half of each leaf, and repeat this process to color the front and back of all pieces. Feel free to use a brush or a cosmetic sponge to blend or brush off any excess pastel. It's up to you, whatever you think looks best. This is what my first piece looks like. Repeat this process for the remaining pieces. Here I am using a small 1/8 inch dowel and wrapping the sides of each leaf around the dowel. You can also use your scraper tool and fold each side of the succulent leaf around the edge of the scraper. This works perfectly for the smaller pieces. For the smallest piece, fold up the leaves to the center. Again, we will assemble the succulent starting with the largest to smallest piece. Add hot glue to the center of the largest piece. Place the next size leaf on the glue and stagger the leaves. And continue until all of your pieces are assembled. Apply floral wire to the back of the succulent using the same method and measurements that we did for succulent number 2 and 3. For this next succulent, you will need the pieces for succulent number 7, along with Ranger Seedless Preserves Distress Ink. This is the Semper Vivum Jubilee. All right, so take your sponge and press it into the ink pad and then apply the ink to the outer edges of each leaf, just like we did for succulent number 2. Once you've added color to all the leaves on the front, flip the piece over and add color to the back. Continue applying color to the outer edge for the remaining pieces, front and back. Use the scraper tool to shape each leaf like we have done with the succulents that we've already made. And then continue shaping each leaf except the 2 smallest pieces. For those 2 pieces, you'll want to bend the 4 leaves toward the center. Assemble the succulent pieces, largest to smallest, by adding hot glue in the center. And remember to stagger the leaves. Follow the process to add floral wire to the bottom of the succulent, just like we did for our earlier succulents. Now we'll assemble our Aeonium Green platters. Grab the pieces for that succulent piece, along with the Ranger Forest Moss Distress Ink. Take your sponge and press it into the ink pad, and then apply the ink to the outer edges of each leaf like we did for succulent number 2. Once you've added color to all the leaves on the front, flip the piece over and add color to the back. Continue applying color to the outer edge for the remaining pieces, front and back. Use the scraper tool to shape each leaf like we've done with the succulents that we've already made. When you get to the smaller pieces, use a 1/4 inch or a 3/16 inch dowel to shape the leaf. And for the smallest piece, fold the leaves in toward the center. Assemble the succulent pieces, largest to smallest, by adding hot glue in the center, and stagger the leaves like we've done with all of our other succulents. And then when it's done, add floral wire to the bottom of the succulent just as you've done before. Now we'll assemble another Semper Vivum, but this time color the leaves using pan pastel magenta on the very tips and yellow tint for the rest of the leaf. Continue adding color to the front and back of each piece, and for the 2 small pieces, color the leaves using only magenta. Then stack, stagger, and glue all of the pieces bottom to top and add the floral wire to the bottom. Next, we'll assemble 2 more Monstera leaves, the same as we did earlier, but this time in a different shade of green. Using the permanent green pan pastel with a cosmetic sponge, I'm adding random color to various parts of the front and back of the leaf. And then I use my scraper tool again to give the leaf shape. Now cut out a piece of floral wire approximately 3 to 4 inches long and cut it with your wire cutters. Add about an inch of hot glue to the end of the wire and place a half inch of the hot glue end to the back side of the leaf where the stem is. And take the stem of the leaf and begin wrapping it around the other half of the hot glue. This next succulent, called the Aeonium urbicum or salad bowl, goes together just like our first one. This time, however, we will color the bottom half of the leaf with pan pastel yellow ochre and use red extra dark for the tips of the leaves. When you've finished adding color to the front, continue with the back side of the piece. And then follow the same steps from succulent number one to assemble and add the floral wire to the bottom. This next succulent is called a Crassula nudicaulis, also referred to as the devil's horns. We will use sponges and pan pastel magenta to color the petals. Wipe a cosmetic sponge into the magenta pastel and add it to the outer half of each leaf. Flip the piece over and continue adding color to the back. Then continue adding color to all of the remaining pieces and use your scraper tool to shape the leaves. We're going to assemble this succulent so that the leaves are pointing up. Start with the largest piece and work to the smallest. Add hot glue to the center of the largest piece. Again, you don't need a lot of hot glue here. And place the next piece on top and stagger the leaves. Continue until you've glued all of the pieces together. Add the floral wire to the bottom of the succulent as we did with succulent number two. This next succulent is a Portulaca molokiniensis. It calls Hawaii home. We will use our pan pastel and permanent green to color its leaves. Apply color from the center toward the edges of each leaf, and then add color to the back of each piece. Repeat this process for all pieces except the four smallest pieces. This is what the pieces look like all colored. Mold the leaf using a Cricut scraper tool and place the leaf on top of the edge of the scraper and pull. Place the scraper tool near the middle of the leaf and pull to the edge. Take the next smallest piece and use a small 3/16 inch wooden dowel to curl each leaf. For the three smaller pieces, fold each leaf toward the center. Assemble the pieces beginning with the four larger pieces. Add glue to the center of the piece and stagger the leaves. Now assemble the next five largest pieces, but have the leaves for these pieces going up. Continue until all pieces are assembled and add the floral wire just as we did earlier. This next succulent is called a Sempervivum tectorum, also commonly referred to as hens and chicks, and it's called that because of the habit of the plant to produce lots of babies. This succulent goes together just like the second succulent that we made. This next succulent is called Grapativaria Fred Ives, and we'll use pan pastel magenta on the outer edges of the leaves and red extra dark in the very middle of each leaf. We will again use a small dowel to shape the leaves and our scraper tool to bend them. Then assemble it, starting with the largest piece to the smallest piece, staggering and gluing each layer. Be sure to add the floral wire to the back as well. Now this succulent is called the Colonco flapjacks, also known as the petal plant. We will use pan pastel magenta to add a splash of red around the edges of each leaf. Use a scraper tool to shape the leaves and continue assembling and add the floral wire. Our next succulent is called the Greenovia dodentralis mountain rose. We'll use pan pastel permanent green, yellow tint, and magenta to color the leaves. Color the pieces from smallest to largest. For the first four pieces, color the pieces with permanent green. Color the remaining pieces, except the two largest, using magenta. Then take a hint of yellow tint to the end of each leaf. Now for the two largest pieces, color the outer half of a leaf with yellow tint and the inner half of a leaf with permanent green. Use the scraper tool to shape each leaf. And when you get to the smaller pieces, use the small dowel to shape the leaf. And for the smallest piece, fold the leaves toward the center and then glue it all together. This succulent is called the Semper Vivum Silver King, and we will use Pan Pastel Red Extra Dark and Grass Green. Begin coloring the bottom two-thirds of each leaf with Red Extra Dark, and then color the tip of each leaf using Grass Green. Shape all of the leaves using a scraper tool except the smallest three. For the three smallest pieces, take an 1/8-inch dowel and shape the leaves so that they come to the center of the piece. And continue assembling and add the floral wire. Now we'll color the leaves of our next succulent, also known as Pacific Devil's Food, with Pan Pastel Yellow Ochre Ink. Shape the leaves and use hot glue to assemble the leaves just like we did earlier. This succulent, called the Malaco, is the same as the first succulent that we made, but we will use Pan Pastel and Abandoned Coral on the outer edge of each leaf. And last but not least, our final succulent is called the Aeonium Arboreum Zwartkop. Yes, that is the name of it. For this succulent, color each leaf by adding Ranger Forest Moss Distress Ink to the inner half of each leaf. For the four smallest pieces, color each leaf entirely using Ranger Crushed Olive Distress Ink. And then continue assembling and add floral wire. Feel free to play with different shading techniques for your succulents. Curling the leaves under or over will give each succulent a completely different look. The most important part is to have fun. Succulents come in a variety of colors and shapes, and they're so beautiful. Step 5, assemble your succulent tray. Now that we have plenty of paper succulents made, it's time to add them to our tray. Get your tray and all of your assembled succulents together. Begin arranging your succulents in your tray by sticking the floral wire through the moss and into the floral foam. The cool thing about having the floral wire at the bottom of each succulent is that you can move the succulents around until they are placed exactly how you want them. If you find that your floral wire is too long, just use your wire cutters to snip them a little shorter. And once you're happy with the arrangement of your succulents, remove a succulent from its placement. Add hot glue to the tips of the floral wire and then return it to its spot immediately. This helps secure the succulent in place and ensures that they won't fall out when you're moving your tray. You can also use your paper succulents and add them to a pot, a mug, or a basket. The possibilities, combined with your creativity, are endless.
This is what my finished succulent tray looks like. Isn't it gorgeous? It's really just amazing. Now this paper succulent tray is a great addition to any home decor. It looks amazing hanging on a wall or placed on a countertop or a table. And the best part is that they're maintenance free, and yes, you can't kill them. The paper succulent tray also makes an awesome gift. Now, if you have any questions about cutting or assembling my paper succulents, please let me know. Leave your question below this video or ask over at our Cricut Crafters group at jennifermaker.com/CricutCrafters. I love to help and see you succeed, and I would love to see you make these beauties. And that's it for today. Until next time, this is Jennifer Maker reminding you to craft a life you love.